event. That's what adds the difference, because at this circuit, it's really hard to get around. He was clearly quicker over the last four laps, toe-to-toe, but he still had to fight to get around him. That's what a street circuit will do to you.
Mark made the point before about the David being able to drive his car on the sprint tyre, the soft tyre, straight. Paul Dumbrell hasn't had that benefit. Yeah, he's had to work a lot harder, dealing with the traffic, exciting the throttle to be able to manoeuvre the car around. I'm pretty certain of the fact that by the time he finds this clean air that he's in now, he won't be in the same sort of grip position that David Reynolds is.
Well, last time around, David Reynolds did a 1:13.9. Paul Dumbrell did a 1:15.4, having to work his way through all that traffic.
Yeah, the traffic, the battle that he was having with Will is going to play a major role in the lap time there.
No doubt. And when you do it, when you're actually trying to get by, you have to use the throttle hard now, don't you? You can't just apply the throttle gently and do what I said about the short shifting, etc. You have to work it hard to do it. That's a great shot.
David Reynolds is so far ahead, he's out of range of our chopper. He's 3.6 seconds further up the road. This is coming down to turn 11. Beautiful amphitheatre here. Grandstand seating. As they come around, snake around 12. And the drivers always talk about the crowd here. You can hear one of those rare places where you can hear the crowd above the roar of a V8 supercar. Carnival atmosphere. Lots of stuff for everybody to do. And there is our race leader. Now 3.6 seconds it remains. Clear of Mark Winterbottom. Dumbrell's waiting to pounce.